talking about fueling up before and after you work out and also learning how to read your labels. Joining us this morning, Pooja Vyas, a registered dietitian, to talk about what you should be looking for while you're shopping at the grocery store. Good morning. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Maddie.
All right, so why is it important to fuel your body, and why does it matter what you put in before and after a workout?
Okay, so nutrition is very optimal pre and post workout. You just have to make sure you know what your goal is. A lot of times people are on a diet basically based off they want to gain weight, lose weight, weight maintenance. Some of them are athletes, endurance and strength training. So having to know what product you're picking is very important, and so the nutrition label becomes very vital.
Okay, so let's start with drinks, because people often, you know, think, okay, I'm working out, I'm sweating, I gotta have that sports drink, I've gotta have those electrolytes, but sometimes the first thing we reach for is not really the best for us at all.
Correct. So most ideal would be coconut water if you're just working out less than an hour. So if you're someone as an athlete who's working out more than 1 to 2 hours, definitely you're sweating more. So the more you sweat, you need electrolytes, and that's what it's all about when it comes to sports drink. It's like replenishing a body with electrolytes and carbohydrates based on your intensity of the workout. So this would be an ideal pick just because it has electrolytes by, which we talk about is sodium and potassium, you know, the most normal ones. And the body gets to deplete sodium very quickly, and that's the first time, you know, when we think, when we're sweating, it tastes salty. So people, that's what it is about.
And people think like, oh, if I need electrolytes, I have to have this. But this, unfortunately, has like more than twice the amount of sugar you're supposed to have in an entire day. So
correct.
You can get electrolytes from a lot of other things is the point. You don't have to reach for sugar. Just learn to read your labels. And then when it comes to food sources, what kind of food do our muscles need to recover after?
Correct. So if you're someone who's working out a lot and, you know, are into like weightlifting twice or thrice a week, something which you need is protein. And most of this body, which I highly recommend, it's because of the personal use, would be this, and this are high. It gives you carbohydrates and protein in a really good balance and has a fiber as well. So this would come out as a really good option. After years of, you know, going through grocery aisles, these are my selected few which I would bet on. Kind of, sort of, gives you what you need, but not definitely the only choice. So if you're eating pre and post just a very balanced diet, it should give you enough nutrition.
How much protein do you want after a workout?
So, as I said, again, it's the intensity of the workout, how much you're sweating, what's your goal. So it's like the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics would recommend anywhere from 0.6 to 0.8 grams per kilogram of body weight for just a regular, normal individual. It goes higher as much as 1.2 to 1.5 grams per kilogram of body weight, depending on the higher intensity workout.
Okay, but a good bar like that comes from natural whole ingredients.
Correct.
You can literally, I mean, I think there's 5 ingredients total there.
Correct, so, and that's why it's perfect.
Key.
Like, you know, shorter the ingredient list, better. I always say look for anything between 8 to 10 ingredients, and that makes it easier for you to pick the right bar for yourself.
All right, Pooja Vyas, thanks so much for joining us this
Thank
morning.
You.
We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
We'll be right back after this.